Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today, I'll be reading a history of the Western Heartlands, which I found right here in Arlond and Farthindel's house in Gullykin. History of the Western Heartlands. The history of the Western Heartlands is a history of endless battles and destroyed empires. In ancient times, these were the lands of the fallen kingdom of Illifarn, the lost kingdom of man, and rumored Netherrell. In more recent history, the land has been fertilized with blood and bone as forces from the empires of the sands surged northward, the evil peoples within Dragonspear and the goblin marches spilled forth, and mercenary companies moved to and fro in the service of one petty warlord after another. Recent battles leveled the way in and threatened Daggerford. Even the time of troubles did not leave this desolate land unmarked. Baal himself perished at Borskira Bridge, and the waters it passes over have remained poisoned to this day. The cities of the Western Heartland are strong, independent, and varied. They are also strongly motivated by trade and listen harder to the ringing of gold than the call of battle. But something else prospers in the open land, freedom and opportunity. No nation lays claim on the Western Heartlands to land beyond that which their armies can control, and no warlord can make demands beyond the swing of his axe. Small holds and castles regularly spring up, only to be knocked down by invading forces or abandoned after a generation or two. Lost dungeons and secret citadels lie scattered throughout the land, and this rugged frontier presents more than enough opportunities for adventurers. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, History of the Western Heartlands.